Well, hey guys, welcome back to Cairn Creek. I'm Jeremy here in Southern Ohio. Another rainy weekend. Now, come on, guys. Several things have transpired over the last week. Cairn Creek is expanding. We had an opportunity to buy another piece of property, and we're going to show you that in next week's video. So as I start the intro, like I'm doing now to any video, I always have high expectations on what I think I can get done in a 12-minute period. I might gather this footage over 2 or 3 days, but I try to keep a timeline, a mental timeline, in my head so that I can keep the video as succinct and short as possible to get the point across of what I'm doing. Throw in a little education here and there, and we'll call that a win. Well, you saw the bridge gets constructed in the mill shop last weekend. I think I'm gonna go ahead and try to get this bridge set in the creek, in the rain, the Cairn Creek, as I always say. I think we can get that done today. Our first task will be to go and find some stones. Try to find some stones, probably the size of like a bathtub, if you can get a visual on that. I'm not real concerned about the symmetry of the stones. They can be round, however. We just gotta get them planted down that creek bed. We'll get them notched out, get our posts, get set. Luckily, we have the track go back now. So that's what we're gonna do now. We're gonna go try to find some stones to place in the creek for our footers for the walk bridge. Here comes Mill Shop Kitty. Say hi, Mill Shop Kitty. The owl did not eat Mill Shop Kitty. Right here where we're at, we are two-thirds of the way back in the property, probably a good 3/4 mile back from the mill shop. This area is just littered with rocks that size. We are so blessed to have all these rocks. I don't know what I'll do with them, but eventually it's nice to be able to have these to come up and use if we need it for projects like we're doing now. Let's go ahead and turn the GoPro on because this could be crash city with this big of a rock and these slick conditions and the hill. But the good news is I'm an athlete,
so I got that going.
This one's got potential to be a disaster, but we're gonna try it. It's a Cairn Creek way. Holy cow, didn't I tell you that was gonna be a hot mess? The good news is we're not buried. We got the rock out. Bad news is we've got a little cleanup work here to do on the edge of the fairway. And I know you guys don't like golf, but let's take a quick gander. Golf hole, sweet ass stuff right there. Fairway, a tee box up here. Mill shop. Oh, and you can see the smoke. We got a fire going at the new place across the road. See that smoke way down there? Probably burning stuff we're not supposed to be burning, but it's America. Hot dog, hot dog, hot diggity dog. Finally got some sunshine. Conditions are still not favorable for this project. Let's be honest, I'm working in a creek, so it's gonna be wet and mucky anyways, so we're gonna get started. It took me several hours to actually get to this point today. I had to get those stones, you saw that. Had a heck of a time with that one. It about whooped my butt, but I'm an athlete, didn't give up, come on. All right, back to the bridge, back to the project today. You can see my white paint. I think that's where it needs to go. Now in the last video, some people mentioned getting blocks, we could pour concrete headers. There's all kinds of ways we could support this up. I could even put posts down in the creek bed. The finished product here with these stones from the property, I think the story is told. The story lasts forever with the longevity of the white oak. And then I think these stones, these big rocks, are gonna make an excellent foundation. The water's not gonna move them. And I think it's gonna add to the character of this little project. Like I said, long term, I think it tells a better story. But right now, all the stones are different thicknesses, different heights. So I've got them all predetermined. I know that's 2 foot, one's 32 inches. I've got to get all these dug out and then set close to finish grade at the top, as close as I can get them. But they're not flat. So depending on where the bridge falls, it's going to be up and down. That's a challenge that we're going to have to face today. Let's roll with it. Let's see what we can get going. And I think we'll both quickly understand how this project's going to go. Last little note before we get going here on the equipment. We've been waiting on the excavator to get here. The big excavator would be much handier because these stones are pretty much too big for this mini. So we're just going to have to waller them. There's not going to be a lot of lifting and placing and twisting. It's going to be pretty much dig a hole and hopefully plop them down in there and twist and goosh and deesh and boo, get them in place. I want to set the big rock first. This would be the northwest corner. We're kind of making a little cofferdam. The cofferdam is not a big deal. It just allows me to see our grades and stuff a little better. I think that's deep enough. I think the big rock will fit in there. Let's go grab it. Get the bucket under that part, lift up, and see what the blade can do. See that little lip it just caught? Let's go mobile. Hopefully don't flip us over. Well, I don't think you guys have anything to worry about. Alright, so let's let her back down. Easy, dog, easy. Gonna flip us again. Flip us again. You guys probably done a teeter-totter when you was in elementary school. That's kind of what we're doing. Alright, so let's see if we can work it down in there. Epic fail. I said earlier, goose, whatever I said, here's the wallering around part. Alright, you guys got to see one go down. I'm going to turn these cameras off so I can get some work done. We'll be back in a minute with all four of them set, hopefully. In 3, 2, 1. Got those foundation stones set. Now we're ready for step 7, whatever step we're on, who knows. It's quite simple. Bridge on top of these stones, not to permanently set it, but to bring it over here, set it down, make sure we're gonna catch the stones, and then we gotta mark our post locations, and then we're gonna have to drill out the rocks for the white oak post to go in the rocks, just a little bit. Marking our post locations. Thank you. Alrighty, we just gotta get some more rocks put on this side for a little head wall, bring in some dirt to get our grades correct. This job is going beautifully. I think that's a Woodmizer victory. Once again, Woodmizer comes through. Obviously, we already had this cut, originally purposed for that wedding. Turned out awesome for that wedding. We got to repurpose it for this little bridge. White oak bridge is gonna outlast several of us, I can tell you that, because it's just a durable product. It's a durable wood to use in outdoor, and it's strong, it's really structural. It's gonna hold up to what we need it to hold up for. Well guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. We still really enjoy making these things, putting them together for you guys to watch. Little projects like this, it's really exciting to be able to work on this on our own property, on our own, you know, this was created from right here with the stones. Other than some fasteners, this whole project was pretty handy. I wanna touch on some bad news, kinda, I guess. Last episode, I talked about going down to Destin, Florida. Right now, we're actually Monday that my wife and boys are all down at Destin, Florida. We had a hot job that was going on that we almost got done. The job at the school added more work, which did not allow me to travel down with them. So I'm gonna try to fly down on Tuesday tomorrow. That's when this video comes out, it's on Tuesday. Hopefully I can get that job done tomorrow. I'll be able to fly down and join the family for a little vacation. I'll catch the end of the week with them. My wife's not too proud of this situation, but that's one of the disadvantages of having your own business. I can't just leave a job, it's a big job, and I just can't pack up and roll out and say, hey, I'm going on vacation. It's happened before, hopefully it doesn't happen again, but I'm a big boy and the job I have provides a lot for us. So this is a sacrifice we gotta make, and I'll get down there. We'll still have a good time down in Destin, Florida. Coming up next episode on Cairn Creek, what do you think about Cairn Creek 2.0? So there's an opportunity that came up where I could buy some property across the road. There's a great story to be told with that property. Complete, let me tell you, fixer-upper. It's a jungle right now, but we're gonna get over there, get that thing cleaned up. We're gonna tell you our plans with that new piece of property. It's right across from Cairn Creek. Cairn Creek 2.0 in the next episode, guys. Thanks for watching. Thanks for working with us. Cairn Creek, over and out.